guys, Coach Pedro Marquez here with KO Boxing and Fitness. I'm going to start off by making a quick video on the most fundamental thing in boxing, your stance. For the video, I'm going to use a PVC pipe for a good visual for you guys. You can use a piece of tape, a crack on the line, or on the cement, somewhere on the floor. But I'm going to set this down right here to kind of use this as a way to teach you your stance. In striking, there's two stances. If you're right-handed, you're going to be in what's called the orthodox stance. And if you're left-handed, you're going to be in what's called the southpaw stance. And ultimately, that just determines which hand is going to be your power hand and which one's going to be your jab hand. There's five rules to your stance. All right, we're going to have our toes slightly pointed. We're going to be on the balls of our feet, knees slightly bent with our weight evenly distributed, elbows in tight, and our chin down. So we want to make sure that our toes slightly 45 degree angles, and we want to have a heel-toe relationship. And what I mean by that is the tip of your outside foot is going to line up with the back of your heel on your inside foot, right there. Boom, boom, heel-toe relationship, right? You want to have about 2.5 feet in between your stance. We don't want to be with our toes straight forward. Reason being, it makes us too square on our torso, and I'll show you what that looks like in a second. You don't want to be too wide, and you don't want to be too narrow. Also, you want to make sure that your feet aren't lined up straight on each other. Early on, as you're learning your footwork, there's so much going on that it's easy to forget where your toe placement is at. Again, it shows too much torso, it's charging, you're exposing too much of your body, so you want to be here. The example I like to use, like your fencing. You got a sword right here, staying long, as opposed to being here, you're gonna get stabbed in this torso, right? You don't wanna get hit in the body, stay right here long and narrow with that boxing stance and those toes pointed out. Now, this is where your tape on the ground or the floor or the line that you drew on the ground is gonna come in handy. So what we're gonna do is this is gonna make sure that we're not too narrow with our stance. We're gonna be slightly on the balls of our feet, all right? And this just makes sure that we're able to move forward, back, left, right, quicker, as opposed to being flat-footed, okay? Being lighter on your feet, you can move directions, change directions easier when you're more flat-footed. It also has its benefits. You can load up power shots better that way. But right now, initially learning your stance is always better to learn on the balls of your feet, because that's usually less natural than it is to walk on the flat-footed. So, on the balls of your feet, toes 45 degrees to the outside, knees slightly bent. We're gonna make sure our weight's evenly distributed. You don't wanna lean too far forward here. You don't wanna have too much weight on the back leg. You wanna be about a 50-50 right here on each leg, okay? Elbows in tight, okay? Elbows in tight. You don't wanna make sure that you're not here. Our hand placement is similar to our foot placement. Staggered position with our rear hand back, our lead hand forward. And the same way you have a heel-toe relationship here, you're gonna have a pinky-thumb relationship right here, okay? Pinky, thumb lining up, boom. So you have your lead hand just a little more forward, the same way your lead leg is. Chin down, right here, and this is your boxing stance. Last couple tips on the stance. Make sure that when your knees are bent, you're not too squat, you're not too low. Right? You don't want to squat too far down, because then that's really going to make you tire out, and it's just hard to move right here, right? So you want to make sure you got just a nice, slight little bend. Well, other coaches from other sports would call an athletic stance, basketball, football, volleyball, whatever sport you play, that athletic stance right here where you're not locked out, but you're not too far in the squat. Right here, you're ready to move and you're ready to go in whichever direction.